Hey everyone, welcome to our Pure Convergence, and as we start, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you, God, for this chance that you've given us, Lord, the privilege, oh God, to be with you. Thank you because you are here, you are alive, you are present, Lord, in times of need, oh God. Thank you because you never forsake us, you never leave us, Lord. And as we have this Pure Convergence, let your voice speak to our hearts, let your love, Lord, now rescue us from wherever darkness we are in today. Thank you because you never fail to give us hope, to give us joy, to inspire us to live for you. Let your presence, Lord, be magnified. Let your love, your mercy be exalted in our prayer convergence, O God. In Jesus' name we pray with the power of our Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you.
Is found in the book of Isaiah chapter 46 verse 4. It says there, even to your old age and gray hairs, I am he. I am he who will sustain you. I have made you and I will carry you. I will sustain you and I will rescue you. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, let your voice, O God, as you come into your word, O God, humbly, Lord, let it speak to us, Father, in whatever situation you're in. Let your presence guide us, Lord, let your goodness, Lord, be upon us. Help us, Lord, to discern discern, Lord, kung ano man ang gusto mong ihambala sa mong kabay palagit. You will not be far from what you want us to know. Let your presence be upon us. Let your goodness, Lord, nang shelter us, Lord, from whatever it is that is opposing, O God, your truth, Lord, in our lives. Sustaining with the power of your Holy Spirit. Amen. So, in this passage, I would like to share first what Isaiah has told to the people when they are in time of testing and trial and tribulation. The Israelites are in Babylon at that time, and it says there, even to your old age and gray hairs, I am he. There is that connotation that when we grow old, people will leave us, people will die, people will say goodbye, nga mauna sila sa tun, nga madula sininga kalibutan, even though all of us will surely depart from this temporal world. And sometimes it is filled with sorrow, filled with regret, filled with sadness and loneliness. But God, being loving and merciful as He is, He is giving us this kind of commitment that even though we are in our old age and gray hairs, He is still the Lord. He is still God. I believe that as we old, as we age, there are changes. Some of it are positive and some of it are negative. Some grow in all aspects of them of their lives, intellectually, emotionally, physically, and some are being challenged by what they are facing right now. But God is committed to be our God, not just for this day, not just when we are youth, not just when we are in a position that we have the strength, but even if we don't have the strength, God is still God. I am He who will sustain you. Sustenance, I believe that every one of us is going through rough times, especially if you're Christians, na we go against the culture, we go against the norm, we go against the people's principle. Many times in the Bible, it is stated that na we ought to be set apart. We ought not to conform sa patterns ng kalibutan. When this world says to love your brothers and hate your enemies, Jesus told us to love our enemies and to pray for those who persecute us. When this world is craving to become great, craving to become first, craving to be served, but Jesus in humility, He washed the feet of His disciples, telling us how it is to be humble, how it is to serve other people, because the one who is great or the one who wants to be first must be the servant of all. So that is how God is displaying and portraying how we should live our lives. And sometimes, nang we feel nagkakaubusan ta sa reason to do it, because it takes a lot of effort, it takes a lot of discipline to stay in the narrow road. God is telling us that wide is the road for destruction, and a lot of people find it, but narrow is the gate to life, and only a few find it. And in that narrow road, it is lonely. Sometimes you have to leave a lot of things behind, but God is telling us that He will sustain us. By how? First, He told us that He made us. I have made you. Our existence really have a great part and role in knowing our purpose. There is a story, you know, that gold siya nga faucet, pero hindi siya ma-against ng tubig. No matter how pricey it is, no matter how shiny it is in the eyes of men, but if it will not be used according to its purpose, it is still useless. So, many times in our Christian journey, in our Christian walk, we felt like as if that we don't have purpose for existence. We don't know what are we going to do for the last few days of our lives or for the succeeding days and years of our lives. But God is telling us to always search and seek Him, because He is able to give us that purpose and direction, because He made us. In this world that is full of filters, world full of social media and opinions of other people about this event and that event, God is telling us to always never forget that He made us, that He knew us, He purposed our lives, that you are created for something that God once wanted you to do, and you can do it. You can do it because God had assigned you to do it. And it's unique in you, because there is something in you that God have nakita ni Lord para himuon mo. And I will carry you after that we establish ourselves that we are made from God, we are made by God. He will carry us. Direction comes. Now, sometimes we don't know what to do in our present situation. We go to our friends, but we feel that they don't really know what we're going through. We go to Facebook, we go to internet, we go to whatever things that we could access in our hands. But God is saying it clearly that He will be the one who will carry us. He will be the one who will direct our path. He will be the one who will enable us to stay on the right track, as a shepherd who shapes His people. I have encountered one preaching that tells us na ang staff sang shepherd is not straight, but it is bent sa pinakapunta. It is not just something na pahampak sila, but it is to cling to their necks whenever they go astray. And that is what God wants us to know, that He will carry us. So it's important again to stay in our discipline in reading His word and prayer, because He will be the one to carry us, and He will sustain us, and He will rescue us. Ang last point ta is rescuing us. And ano lang no, it is good to be reminded that without God there will be no direction. So if you feel like you have no direction in your ministry right now, in your life right now, praise God, because you are here in our prayer convergence, and God will surely speak to us, and He will rescue us. Moments that we fail, moments that we don't know, we are drowning in temptations, but God is faithful to provide a way out. God is faithful to provide rescue for every one of us. It's impossible for men, but nothing is impossible for God. There is a way out for every temptation, because that's how faithful our God is, our Lord is. So in Isaiah 46 verse 1, even to your old age and gray hairs, I am he who will sustain you. I have made you, and I will carry you. I will sustain you, and I will rescue you. So let's not forget that the essence of us being a Christian is Christ Himself. And we cannot call ourselves a follower of the Lord if we don't spend time with Him in prayer and in reading His word. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for providing us, Lord, guidance and wisdom to be reminded the importance of being with you, of listening to your direction, God, of allowing you to move in our lives, Father. Let your presence be upon us, that your goodness, Lord, speak to us, Father, and help us not just to become recipient of your grace, but also become a vessel of your grace for other people. Jesus, we pray with the power of our Holy Spirit. Amen. Close this in prayer. Heavenly Father, bless Lord everyone who have listened to your voice. As we come, Lord, let your presence go with us, guide us, encourage us, and help us obey your word, Father. Lord, kabay pa, Lord, nga ang mga prayer namon will be heard, good Father, as you see our intentions and motives, Lord, about listening to your voice and listening to your word. Let your presence be upon us, O God. Guide us and live, Lord, sa sininyang kalibutan, Father. Thank you because you are good. We pray for Pitampi Church for all the prayer concerns, O God, of this nation, of every personal or individual family that we represent, O God. For our pastor, Pastor Lovell, and his family, we pray for blessing, we pray for peace, O God, we pray for wisdom. Let your guidance be upon us and let it not depart from us, Father. Jesus, we pray with the power of your Holy Spirit. Amen. So God bless us all and hope to see you next Thursday.